Hi friends, and welcome to my July Plan With Me video in my bullet journal. It has been a little while since I have checked in with a new journaling video. If you are new to my channel or maybe didn't notice because nothing came up in your subscription box, I skipped the month of June on my channel. It was just a really challenging month. I know it was for a lot of people. There's a lot of things going on in the world and just didn't feel super right to be making frilly bullet journal videos during that time. So my spread was really plain and I just wrote June on the page and in yellow, and that was my theme. My theme was yellow, which works sometimes. I think it's important for bullet journaling to be first and foremost an organizational tool and leave the decorative aspects to the back burner sometimes. So, but we're back at it again in July, and I am so excited to share this spread with you guys. So after my Caduceus Clay spread back in May, I decided to do another Critical Role bullet journal theme. I think I want to make this a series, a regular thing. I've got some ideas for some more characters. But this month for July, I have chosen the character Jester Lavore, the tiefling cleric played by the amazing Laura Bailey, who is just the coolest lady ever. If you've played any major video game, you've probably heard her voice in it because she is very busy. Her voice gets around and she's awesome and just so sweet and lovely. And Jester is also very sweet and lovely. And I thought that she was a really good theme to go with for July because she is full of creativity, creative solutions when things are going wrong. And she's just really positive and sweet. And I think that's a really good mindset to have going into the back half of the year, especially after the kind of craziness and difficult and stressful times that have made up the last few months. It's kind of nice to go into the second half of the year with a bit of a positive attitude and try to just focus on making your part of the world as good as you can. So as I did with my Caduceus spread, I did not use any official art or fan art of Jester. I don't feel super comfortable printing out people's art and putting it in my journal. So I decided to just use some motifs and some references. Anyone who has listened to all of Critical Role will definitely recognize what her cupcake represents here with the dust sprinkled down onto it. Little blueberry cupcake for a blue tiefling. I definitely wanted blue to be my main highlight color for this month because what says Jester more than that awesome little blue tiefling with her blue hair and her baked goods? So I really wanted to pull in all the elements that make Jester so special and so wonderful to watch on the show. And I wanted to bring those to my journal this month. So I'm just finishing up lettering a quote from Jester here on the left. And now I'm going into what's making my July bullet journal spread a little bit different than the past months. So as you can see, I am doing a full spread calendar for July. And this is because as part of resetting and recentering myself for the rest of the year, I wanted to make a few changes and a few edits to the way that I have been planning because what I'm doing right now just hasn't been working super well. I've talked about my planner system a little bit on the channel, but essentially I use a happy planner as sort of a calendar. So I do most of my future planning in my happy planner. I use it to kind of schedule out my week, and then I use my bullet journal as more of lists and collections and to-dos. But using two different planner systems just hasn't been working lately. It's, you know, twice the amount of things I have to remember, and I can barely remember to write in one planner with all the mental strain I've got going on right now. So I decided to just kind of scale things back and simplify them and do all of my July planning in my bullet journal and trying that out for the month. So I will let you know in August how that has gone for me. So far it's going pretty well, 3 days in, but I will let you know if that changes. I'm excited to try something new and I really like the way that I created this calendar. And of course, the main reason that I chose Jester for my theme this month is because Critical Role is back For those of you who don't know, Critical Role is a actual play Dungeons & Dragons show that airs weekly on Twitch, and then the videos get uploaded to YouTube, where a bunch of voice actors play Dungeons & Dragons, and it's wonderful and heartfelt and exciting and dramatic and funny and just so great. It has essentially been the thing that has gotten me through quarantine and through this whole coronavirus situation, has been having these adventures every week, and I caught up just in time for them to come back with their new socially distanced studio, and I got to watch most of the episode 100 last night. I did fall asleep at some point, so I'm gonna have to catch the rest of the on-demand video when that comes out, but it was really wonderful to have that bit of comforting media back. I think that it's something that has been so important for a lot of people to have the consistency of a favorite movie or book or show. I'm so happy that I found Critical Role. I'm so happy that I have Dungeons & Dragons and Critical Role to get me through the days when they're a little too stressful. It's nice to kind of just put it on in the background while I'm cleaning or working on stuff or whatever I happen to be doing that day. And now I am moving into something that's going to look a little bit more familiar to anyone who's watched my past journaling videos. I've got my usual July favorites and my July goals here on the left, and I'll be doing my positivity tracker in just a moment over on the right-hand side. Definitely, Critical Role will be staying in my July favorites. It's been pretty much a staple on all of my favorites lists for the last few months. And I also, today is a very exciting day. I'm recording this on July 3rd, and today both the Babysitter's Club Netflix show and the Hamilton movie on Disney Plus both dropped today, and I have not watched Hamilton yet. I'm going to watch it tonight. I'm so excited, but I have watched the Babysitter's Club, and even if you did not grow up with the books the way that I did, I highly recommend it. The first four episodes were just delightful, and I can't wait to watch more. But I also kind of want to savor it. I don't know if anyone else feels that way sometimes when you really like a show but it only has a finite number of episodes and you almost don't want to finish it because then it will be over and then it'll just be kind of this void of hoping that you get more of the thing that you like, but not sure if that's going to happen because you can never predict that with television. But I will definitely finish it soon, but what I've seen, I've really loved. I really like how they kept the 90s spirit of the show and then kind of brought in this 2020 update. It's more diverse, there's more representation, there's characters of color, there are LGBTQ characters and stories, and I'm just really impressed with how they were able to keep the heart and also update it and make it very modern and relevant and just really, really great. It's so good. And they actually cast the girls at the right age, which is so rare in television. Usually teenagers are cast as being way older, but these girls actually look like they're 12, which is impressive because that doesn't happen super often. Here I'm just finishing up my positivity tracker with another Jester quote, how she uses her thaumaturgy spell as a cleric to open up all the windows whenever they're in a tavern and causes a lot of chaos, because that's Jester. She's causing a lot of chaos. I hope that you have been well. I hope that you have been taking care of yourselves, taking care of your communities, having discussions with your family and friends, checking in with the people that mean the most to you, and just keeping that camaraderie. So we are just getting into the final flip through. I'm so happy with how this spread turned out, and I hope it'll bring lots of positive energy to July. I hope all of you are doing okay, that you are wearing your masks and educating yourselves, keeping an open mind, and trying to make your little corner of the world better than you found it. You can check out the description box below for a link to a couple of websites that show resources, petitions, and places to donate for the Black Lives Matter movement, so you can make the world a better place by helping and supporting those fighting against systemic racism. Until next month, you guys can follow me on Instagram for more updates, and I'll talk to you again very soon. Keep it magical. Bye, guys.